Hey there, welcome back to Dietitians and Nutrition Support. Today we're going to be talking through premixed parenteral nutrition solutions. In previous videos, we've had the opportunity to talk about custom parenteral nutrition solutions in which you get to pick the exact amount of macronutrients and micronutrients that all get compounded into that PN solution for your patient. But what if your institution doesn't have the facilities to be able to custom compound parenteral nutrition, or maybe they don't have the resources, or maybe they don't have enough patients that are on parenteral nutrition that you want to build all of these facilities? Well, here comes the great application of premixed parenteral nutrition solutions. Premixed solutions are just as they sound. They're premixed solutions that contain all of the macronutrients and all the micronutrients that you might want. Now, there are some premixed solutions that will contain all the macronutrients, and there are some that will contain a few of the macronutrients. Same thing can be said about micronutrients. So there's still opportunity to kind of mix and match the various things that you need for your patient, and you can select the most appropriate product on the market or available in your institution to be able to provide all of those pieces to your patient. We've seen a lot of increase in the usage of premixed parenteral nutrition solutions, particularly following natural disasters that lead to product shortages for things such as components that you might compound custom parenteral nutrition with. So in instances in which we don't have all the pieces that we need to make custom parenteral nutrition, this is a really great application for premixed solutions. But notably, there are a ton of other great applications for premixed solutions as well. Before we get to all of those applications, let's first talk through a few of the different varieties of premixed solutions you might see on the market or in your institution. So one of the awesome things about parenteral nutrition is all the different kinds that it comes in. So if we're thinking about these premixed bags, we again have some options. The first option that you might see is called a multi-compartment premixed parenteral nutrition. You can see some of these being a two-in-one compartment bags, meaning that you have amino acids and dextrose. And you may have three-in-one compartment bags that would have amino acids, dextrose, and the lipid emulsion provided. Within the multi-compartment bags, we see each of our macronutrients stored separately, but they have seals between them that can be broken to mix the components prior to infusion. These multi-compartment bags can be available with and without electrolytes added to them. If you're using a two-in-one, you can also provide lipids separately using a Y connector in the primary IV catheter, or you could have lipids that can be mixed into the container following mixing of the amino acids and dextrose. So you've gotten a chance to see a few of the different types of premixed parenteral nutrition solutions that we have, but when are you going to use them? So I've already alluded to the times where you might have a product shortage that leads you to using a premixed solution as opposed to a custom solution, but you could also use them in other instances really successfully. One of the times where you might use the premixed parenteral nutrition solution is going to be if you have a patient starting parenteral nutrition, sometimes potentially in the after hours or over the weekend. If you really need to get someone started on PN and they're a stable patient, it might be a good choice to go ahead and consider doing a premixed bag of parenteral nutrition just until the next day or the next few days when they can get their custom parenteral nutrition recommendations made. You can also see that patients may be successful using a long-term application of a premixed parenteral nutrition solution, particularly when they can meet their needs using the parenteral nutrition solution. So, even though it's going to be premixed and we maybe can't customize it, as long as a patient can meet their needs, they can do successfully using that long-term. We can see a short-term application of premixed solutions also happening with those patients that are maybe transitioning to their PN recommendation. So we may see that again, you know, maybe it's weekend or after hours, or maybe it's sometime during the week that you weren't able to get that custom recommendation in yet, but you can use a standard bag up until that point. Again, most recommended in a stable patient. You could see a great application for premixed solutions within patients who are self-payers for their parenteral nutrition. Sometimes they don't see as great of insurance coverage for individuals who are on parenteral nutrition, and there's patients who are paying for their parenteral nutrition out of pocket. So if that's the instance and you have a patient who can meet their needs for parenteral nutrition on a premixed bag, then you might recommend that You might also see some use of premixed solutions in the pediatric population, and the research is out there to support usage of premixed solutions for a variety of patients and most typically stable pediatric patients, but there isn't as much literature supporting the use in pediatrics as there is in adults. So really make sure that you are knowing a lot about the specific patient that you might be using this in and making sure to make the best recommendation possible for that individual. So thinking about all of this variety of products that are available to us, we also need to be very in tune to our patient's needs and what nutrients we're providing. From a macronutrients perspective, we can provide 2 macronutrients, we can provide 3 macronutrients, but if you get to the instances where you're only providing 2, you need to make sure that you also provide a separate lipid emulsion that's going to come into play, maybe every day, every few days, all depends on your patients, but you're still going to have to provide those lipids somehow. You can also try to make sure that your patients are getting as close as possible to their needs with their premixed bags. You really want to stay close to the needs because if we leave someone too low or too high for too long, we're going to end up with some additional problems. So really trying to meet them exactly where they need to be. From a micronutrients perspective, you can select most formulations with or without electrolytes. And if you choose without electrolytes, know that, again, you're going to have to provide those to your patients separately. You'll also need to make sure that you provide a multivitamin in some capacity because, again, we need people to get all their essential nutrients. You could also need separate electrolyte provisions that you could provide in addition to the premixed solution because maybe the premixed solution doesn't meet what your patient needs, so you might see an electrolyte rider of some capacity also infusing into your individual. And keeping in mind that we can really see application of premixed solutions in a variety of settings. You can really see them in home, in patient care, lots of different opportunities here. So considering all that your patient might need, if you're in home, maybe it needs to be a little less complicated if they're trying to help do that themselves, or maybe if they have a care provider that's assisting. If they're inpatient, maybe they have a little bit extra support, but we just need to be very aware of the environments that our patients are going to be in to make sure that they get all their adequate needs and also have the appropriate products available to them. Note that also with all parenteral nutrition, this is still going to require a lot of monitoring. So making sure that your patients have close contact with dietitians and the rest of their nutrition support team to be able to manage this for the long term. So let's talk about initiation. If you're initiating a premixed parenteral nutrition solution in your patient, be very mindful as to what's going on with your patient. Specifically for malnourished patients or people who are at risk for refeeding syndrome, we want to start low and slow, even with premixed solutions, and definitely with custom solutions as well. We just want to make sure that we're really going probably at the lowest provisions possible for your premixed solution option and very gradually moving up towards their goal. So it may take a few days to work through that initiation period if you have a person who's at risk for refeeding syndrome. From a continuation perspective, we can see people continue on a premixed parenteral nutrition solution for the long haul, so long as they're able to meet all of their needs for macro and micronutrients. Even if it's a premixed solution or a custom solution, remember that we'll still have to keep all of those safety factors in place to make sure that they are infusing safely and healthfully and getting all of their needs, regardless of what kind of parenteral nutrition it is. Let's talk through some pros and cons of these premixed parenteral nutrition solutions. As I kind of noted earlier, starting out on our pros list, it can be more affordable for institutions or individuals to utilize a premixed parenteral nutrition solution as opposed to a custom. Again, this is very dependent on the situation, as you'll find that some institutions are able to really cut down costs using custom solutions, but for others, it is less expensive to use a premixed solution. You'll also see that, again, if you're using a premixed solution and you don't have any custom solutions that are being synthesized at your institution, this does not require any specific facilities for compounding these solutions on site. So this can decrease the need for those additional facilities as well as potentially for extra personnel to be able to compound those solutions. So sometimes that can be a positive for various institutions, and particularly small institutions, if they are not able to get all of those resources. We also see that parenteral nutrition in these premix bags is super successful for a lot of the kind of average or standard patients that we might have, so long as we can meet their needs. This can be sometimes for an adult population and sometimes for a pediatric population, but there really are a wide range of applications, making premix solutions a super great choice. From a cons perspective, I think it is pretty obvious that these premix solutions don't offer the same customization capacity that a custom parenteral nutrition bag has, which means that if your patient has really unique needs in terms of macronutrients or micronutrients, it may be challenging to find the most appropriate choice of a premix solution, or you may not be able to actually meet your patient's needs on a premix solution. So if that's the case, then a custom solution, if available, might be the best option. We also see that it's particularly challenging to use premixed solutions for patients who are on a fluid restriction, for patients who are critically ill, and for patients who have organ dysfunction. So note that there are some times in which premixed solutions aren't necessarily the best choice. Sometimes they're the only choice, and we just do the best that we can with the resources that we have, but note that there are some instances in which a custom might be the most beneficial choice for our patient. And one final note for the cons list is that if you're using a premixed solution, they're probably coming from some sort of company that compounds the solutions and then ships them directly to your institution or directly to the patient. So if this is the case, it will make the situation dependent on the outside source of the premixed parenteral nutrition solutions. Overall, I hope that this has been helpful for you to learn a bit more about premixed parenteral nutrition solutions, what might be in them, and when you might use them, as well as some pros and cons to their application in your patients. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments boxes below, and we look forward to seeing you next time.